Back from the West and unable to find lodging in Baroda by Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, a short summary. Ambedkar was sent for higher studies in 1913 to America by the Maharaja of Baroda. In 1970, he came to London and continued his studies in the London School of Economics. In 1980, he came back to India and joined Baroda government service. 5 years of life in America and England had taken away from his mind the feeling that he was an untouchable. But when he came out of the station, he was disturbed by the thought of finding a lodging. The Hindu hotels would not accept an untouchable. He asked a hackney coach driver whether there was a hotel in the camp, and he said there was a Parsi inn, as Parsis did not practice untouchability, and Ambedkar decided to go to the Parsi inn. The driver brought him to the place. The Parsi inn was a two-story building. On the ground floor lived the caretaker with his family. Ambedkar was given a room on upstairs. When the caretaker came up with a book in his hand, he found that his guest had no sadra and kasti, the white Muslim vest and the thread on the waist that distinguished a Parsi. The caretaker told him that it was an inn for the Parsi only and a Hindu could not be accommodated there. Ambedkar tried to make a compromise with him by suggesting to write a Parsi name in the book. He agreed and Ambedkar felt relieved, but it was to be a short-lived relief. The first floor of the inn had a small bedroom and a bathroom adjoining to it. The rest was a big hall which was torn with the broken furniture. Ambedkar was the sole occupant of the floor. The caretaker brought him breakfast and dinner but did not stop to talk to him. Ambedkar was appointed as a probationer in the Accountant General Office. He left the inn at 10 a.m. and returned early in the night to avoid detection by others. He was alone on the floor and there was no light of any kind. He felt that he was in a dungeon. He found relief from loneliness by reading books. His state was so pitiable that when his sister's son came with his luggage, he began to cry loudly. He wanted to escape from the place and applied for a state bungalow to stay in, but they did not treat the matter urgently. On the 11th day of his stay, he was detected. A group of sturdy Parsis with sticks in their arms came up in the morning and began to question him. They asked him why he had polluted the Parsi in impersonating Ep as a Parsi. They would have beaten him up but his meekness. He asked them to give him a week's time to vacate, but they gave him the ultimatum to quit the place by the evening. Ambedkar sat there for some time, weeping and thinking. He had no untouchable friend in Baroda to stay with. He went to a Hindu friend who told him that if he came to his house, his servants would quit. Then he went to a Christian friend. He and his wife were Brahmins who had converted to Christianity. The wife was still very conservative and would not suffer an untouchable to stay in their house. It was 4 o'clock in the evening when he left the house of his friend. The only option to him was to return to Bombay. The train to Bombay was at 9 o'clock. He had 5 hours to wait. He was afraid to go back to the inn, so he spent the time in the public garden. At 8 p.m. he went to the inn and collected his baggage. The caretaker was silent. He took the money and Ambedkar took his leave in silence. It was on this occasion that he realized that a person who is untouchable to a Hindu is also an untouchable to a Parsi. So this is a summary of Back from the West and Unable to Find a Lodging in Baroda. This is the real life experience of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He is an untouchable and he has suffered a lot with this caste system. This incident taught Ambedkar the lesson that in India, even the Parsi religion is not free from the evil custom of untouchability. An untouchable to a Hindu is an untouchable to a Parsi also.